I chose 7 o'clock, so I'd like to call this meeting of the April meeting to order. If you join me in the pledge to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Brian, will you please call the roll?
Emily Keeloff.
Here.
Cinder Keeler.
Here.
Tom Lingby.
Here.
Brian Miller.
Here.
Glenn Newcomer.
Here.
Thank you.
You have in your packet the March regular and April special board meetings. There are no questions regarding those meetings. I would entertain a motion to approve those minutes.
So moved.
Glenn, second please.
One second.
Please call the roll, Glenn.
Cindra.
Yes.
Tom.
Yes.
Brian.
Yes.
Glenn.
Yes.
Emily.
Yes. And we do have some public participation today.
So we have Dr. Judy May Jackson representing the Northwest Ohio School Boards Association. So welcome.
Thank you so much. This is quite possibly the most comfortable board chair. I'm just going to sit here for a moment. Thank you so much, Diana. And also, is it your secretary?
Yes, Jane Whistler.
Jane, you guys are just fabulous. But anyway, I am here on behalf of OSBA. I am the regional manager for these 20 counties in this area, and Thomas, you have gotten much communication from me, and don't say you haven't, because you have. I'm so happy. Now that I see you, you can't ignore myself. But one of the things we do is we honor our veteran board members at each of our conferences, and when they cannot attend, we then go out, I take my truck around the countryside, and we like to deliver them, because you are our people, and like you to know. So tonight I have one for Ms. Emily Ebo. I'm going to read her bio, and then before we do the shake hands and take pictures, I have a couple
of... I'm going to shake your hand because I have a pretty bad cold today. Thank you.
Oh, now you realize I'm a teacher, right? I'm just going to say it.
Well, you've got all the germs already. Okay.
I've got them all. But I received a bio, and it says that Emily Ebo and her husband Gary have 4 children who are all Bryan School graduates, Misty, Jessica, Bronson, Ashley. And they have 4 grandkids? Do you really?
More now, but yeah.
Emily is a member of the Bryan Area Foundation and the Bryan City Park Board, and is currently president of the Council of the First Lutheran Church in Bryan. And you've served on the board since 2001. I just want to say that we really appreciate your service. It's 15 years. We have a certificate that was actually from last year, which would have been from Eric Gurman, our good friend who was president. I also have a couple of the things I'd like to share with the whole board, and this is an impassioned plea. One of the goals on my 2016 and 17, as far as regional manager, my first job is I work at Bowling Green State University as a professor. This is my get the kids through my college gig. But I loved it so much, I really do enjoy it. One of my goals was really to engage a board member from Williams County to join our executive committee. Now, before you, I just want to tell you, it isn't that much. And what I'm going to pass out to you is, if you look kind of right down here, it just talks about what we do as committee. We literally meet 3 times a year. I feed you a lunch. And the main thing is that we like to hear from you. We plan all kinds of events, and we don't have anyone from Williams County, Fulton County, and so it's harder for us to know what works for you guys if we don't have someone. Most of the communication is really done via emails, and don't really have to do a lot, but I feel like I don't know you guys other than harassing Thomas. I don't know any of you, so it's a matter of we do meet, and we have lunch, and then we just kind of talk about things. So this is one of the things that I would ask you to think about, is that we have 2 fall conferences coming up. One is going to be at Penta, but the other one is going to be at 4 County Career Center, which is not too far from you guys. So yeah, it is. So anyway, one of the things we're looking for is our focus. There's And on one of these, you see we have five regions. Ours is the Northwest, and each region has its own personality. Ours really is focusing on kids. We highlight kids all the time, what they're doing. That's just our thing. One of the things we're looking for this year is we want students to present to us their homemade videos involving you, school board members, parents, superintendents, principals, anyone, about their great acts of kindness and what it means to their school district. So I'll pass that to you. That is due on June 30th, as well as our other award nominations. So my goal is, I'm hoping one of you will help me keep my job by becoming a Northwest Region OSBA member, and my president, Bob McFerrin, at local, would be very proud of my efforts to reach out. So that is my spiel for today. And also, I found this when I was going through getting my award today. I had an award for you guys that was from a DJ. Rick Small. Do you know Rick?
Yes.
Oh, he's amazing. Anyway, he came to our conference and he presented these, but I still have one for Bryan from 2015. So I'm going to leave it here. It's dirty. Whoever did the Kids for Christmas for Kids campaign in the high school. This belongs to them.
Oh, awesome.
So, would you clean it up before you get it? It's a mess. So now I would like to hand you your award, and young man. Would you mind taking a picture?
Absolutely.
And this will be, of course, plastered all over. I am so bad.
There you go, Emily, front and center.
We don't actually have to touch that.
I'm not going
to
touch it.
Okay. You can hold this. Emily,
hold this guy.
Pass the evil. And,
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. And then you smile really nice, because it's going to be going everywhere.
Take a couple here. One, two, three.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You
thank
so
you so
much,
much. For making the drive.
I appreciate it. And I had to recently get out of class. It's not a bad thing. And I am teaching tonight, so I am going to roll one
right
out
that's
here.
That's fine. Thank
but,
you.
I will be harassing. Are you a board member?
Cindra.
Yeah.
Cindra Maine.
Board member?
Glenn.
Huh?
Yes. Ryan's a kid on the board.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Just want to say thank you so much for all you do. I really appreciate it. And you'll be hearing from me. I hope to see you at least at the fall conference. Come here before I come.
All right.
So
thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Cindra, I think we're ready for Core County Career Center report.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Very nice. Short report, just saying that it's contract time for the staff, just like it is here, and that there are contests still going on. So I hope to have an update for the board at our meeting of any of our Bryan students that were winners. Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Rossworm, your turn.
Okay. Review the financial reports for the month ended March 31, 2017. Our cash reconciliation report, at Farmers and Merchants Bank, our balance was $12,527,806. Outstanding checks and adjustments, $52,881. Investments at Star Ohio, $3,250,928. At Morgan Stanley, $11,767,917. At State Bank, $6,135,229. Petty cash and change funds totaled $7,500 for a total balance of $33,636,499 at the end of March. Our general fund balance at the end of March was $13,630,535. We had just received our first half property tax settlement from the county auditor, which left our balance higher than normal. Our bond retirement fund has a balance at $1,206,005. Our permanent improvement fund, a balance of $2,618,244. Our construction fund, locally funded initiative portion was $1,222,447. Our construction fund local share, $9,631,257. And the state share of the construction fund, $4,295,153. Once again, those are the major funds. Our balance, once again, $33,636,499. Our SM2 report, reviewing our revenues, were $273,000 ahead of budget for the fiscal year, and our expenses are about $413,000 below budget. So we have a positive variance this time of $686,000 as compared to budget. Any questions regarding those reports? If not, we'll move on to amended appropriations. Our appropriations total $38,512,099 at the end of March. Some of the major changes are increase in food service fund by $38,000, increase to the building project, the local share and state share of $195,000. Locally funded initiatives were increased by $13,815. Permanent Improvement Fund increases of $14,607. The total increases last month were $285,499. Any questions regarding the amended appropriations? Now we'll move on. We ask permission to establish a new fund for the class of 2023. It'll be fund number 200-967-T. I'd like to recognize some donations made to the district, $325 plus food items for the Bear Bag Program was donated by the First Brethren Church. Also food items for the Bear Bag Program from the First Church of Christ. And finally, a $250 donation to the Cy Daly Scholarship Fund from Dean and Mary Grove. We also ask that you pass a resolution to advertise for bread bids with Meta, and also a resolution to advertise for bus bids for 71 passenger bus, also with Meta. Any questions? Approve that much, and then we'll move on to the other.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I would entertain a motion then to approve the treasurer's report, the amended appropriations, and the resolution to advertise for bread and bus bids.
So moved.
Second, please.
I'll second.
Please call the roll.
Tom?
Yes.
Brian?
Yes.
Lynn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Senator?
Yes.
Thank you. Next item is a resolution authorizing the advertisement and solicitation of bids for Schaefer Field improvements. These are going to be improvements to the terrace area on the north end of the stadium to make them ADA compliant. We had.
And I did bring a photo in case the board wanted to take a look. So it shows the what the ADA judge has indicated to us is that we need to put a non-slip, non-skid surface on the first.
Just currently we have just gravel.
Currently we just have gravel, stone, on the first two levels. And we also need to be able to supply, if needed, companion chairs for anyone who may want to access those. The height does not require a railing. But we are going to keep the non-skid surface below the level of the stone so that there's a stop there.
Yeah, a lip. So.
A lip, yes. Okay. And then it'll also tie in.
What kind of surface are you anticipating is going to
be? It's going to be concrete, I believe. Is that
correct?
Concrete.
Yes, so fresh concrete with plenty of non-skid surface.
Sure. Yeah.
And this is just on the north end.
Okay, that's all.
Mm-hmm. Architect's estimate for that project is $90,000.
And it is something that we don't have an option. We have to. We're required by ADA to be compliant.
We have been court ordered to get this done.
Okay. We thought we'd be compliant with having the access.
We did.
And then they said it's not sufficient.
Correct.
Because they wanted this additional improvement. Okay. Any questions?
If not, I will entertain a motion to approve the announcement for bids.
So moved. Second.
Glenn, please call the roll.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Cindra?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Thank you. And finally, change order for the pre-K to 5 building construction project. The amount of this change order is $128,347.79. This is for terrazzo improvements in the hallways, at the doorways, to match up the terrazzo, also along the ledges, and in the restrooms to provide terrazzo in those areas. Those are with Rudolph Libby through their construction contract.
Questions? Make a motion to approve.
So moved.
Tom, second, please.
I'll second.
Thank you, Cindra. Please call the roll.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Cindra?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Yes.
Thank you. That concludes my report. Thank you.
Okay. Any old business, Diana?
I will say I have not been in the building in the past week and a half of the new renovation. However, from the outside, people driving by, they're starting to work on the roof, and they're starting to continue along the front side of the building, replacing the EFIS on the first floor and the windows. But I have not been inside lately. I know that we have our next core meeting at the end of this month. And we'll have a better update then for the board. But I don't know, Tom or Glenn, if you guys can help me out, if you've been by the site a little bit more frequently than I have in the past couple weeks.
I was in it last Friday, and Thursday, I think. And it much like has been over the previous weeks. I mean, there is just steady progress every week. I mean, they're moving along. The upper level truly is ready to finish. I mean, you know, put the floor down. They get the EFIS done on the front side of the building where they can put the windows in. They can finish the upstairs real quickly. And each phase, starting on the upper level, moving to the west end of the upper level, and then coming back to the lower level east end, and moving to each phase is just sequentially moving right along. I think everything was pretty well boarded up and puttied and painted. They were painting everything. I think painting has pretty much started in almost all of the academic portions. It's moving along quite well. I talked with some of the tradespeople. Everybody's got a nice upbeat attitude about it. They think things are going along well. You know, no major problems have manifested themselves beyond what would normally be expected. So I think right now everything's looking fine.
Timetable's looking good for fall?
Yeah, I mean, it'll, you know, there's... Realistically, I think they still are going to be hustling when it gets down to the end, but that's just the nature of the game. But they don't appear to have any major obstacles to overcome, which is huge.
Okay, thank you.
All
right. Super, under administrative recommendations this evening, for the 2017-18 school year, a workbook and supply fees, which will remain consistent with what we've had this school year. Preschool tuition for typical $75 per month. Fees for annual kindergarten through grade 8, $50 per year. And grades 9 through 12, $110 per year. I'd like to designate May 8th to the 12th as Employee Recognition Week for Bryan City Schools. And a reminder to the board, I think most of you have signed up, but that Wednesday morning we'll do a board visitation with staff members. Would like to recommend for the 17-18 school year our contract with the NWOESC Service Center for our same services as this year. They help us with hearing handicap services, physical therapist services, attendance, legal retainer, SVH handicap services, mentor program, and gifted supervisor services. In your packet, you have an overnight trip request from our high school choir. This is their their turn at their trip over spring break for next year, and they're asking permission to travel to New York City. So again, this will be during spring break, so students will not miss class, and the band this year went to the bowl game over Christmas break, and next year's choir, the year after that, will be orchestra, and then we'll have a year off. So the packet of information is included, and this has been a trip that we've taken for many, many years that I've been here. Approval of a student who has met all the graduation requirements. Unfortunately, Shayla Rivera was unable to be with us tonight, but we congratulate her for meeting both the State of Ohio requirements and the Bryan City School requirements at this time. So her graduation date will be effective March 17th. Any questions regarding those issues? If not, I will entertain a motion to approve the administrative recommendations.
Also move to approve.
Second, please.
I'll second.
Glenn, please call the roll.
Emily?
Yes.
Cinder?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Thank you.
Under commendations, it is already the end of the third quarter, believe it or not. So we have our All A Honor Roll and our Students of Action for the Character Trait of Forgiveness for the high school. Middle school, we have our third quarter All A Honor Roll and our Students of Action for Forgiveness. And at our Bryan Elementary 2-5 campus and Washington Elementary, we have our Character Trait Student Award winners for forgiveness. Our PE Gold Slip winner, Harley Genter at the Portland campus, and Charlotte Durbin and Lucy Grimm at our Washington campus. And then finally, we recognize our PE Character Trait classrooms, Mrs. Bierke and Mrs. Taylor. Okay, very nice. I need a motion to approve the commendations, please.
All right.
So moved.
Second, please.
Second.
Right. Please call the roll.
Cinder?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Thank you.
Under personnel recommendations, we accept with regrets the resignation of Kathy Detweiler as a kindergarten intervention teacher effective June 30th, as well as Colleen Gaylor, Washington Elementary CD classroom teacher effective June 30th. In our OPC union, Tom Hall, bus driver, will be retiring at the end of this year, as will Sandy Oberlin, elementary head lunchroom cashier, both effective June 30th. So we wish all of those employees the best in their retirement and thank them for their many years of service to Bryan City Schools. Under some recommendations for a new hire, we have Lauren Snyder as a preschool one-on-one crossing guard aide, 3.75 hours per day, 4 days a week, 0 years experience. That was effective April 4th. That was for a student that moved in with some physical disabilities. And Scott Stuckey, bus mechanic, 8 hours a day, 260 days a year, 9 years experience, effective April 10th. We'd like to offer 1 year limited teaching contracts for the 17-18 school year to Kayla Beatty, Grade 5 classroom intervention teacher, bachelor's level, 0 years experience on the A1 salary schedule, pending receipt of her supplemental license. Colton Royer, 9 to 12 intervention teacher, bachelor's level, 0 years experience on the A1 salary schedule, pending receipt of his Ohio license. And we have with us tonight Zeb Frank, grade 5 classroom teacher for ELA social studies, bachelor level, 0 years experience on the A1 salary schedule, pending receipt of his Ohio license.
Thank you.
We'd like to transfer classified personnel Angie Fackler to the 6 to 12 campus, third shift custodian, 8 hours a day, effective March 27th. Increase in hours due to a bus transfer for Sherry Robinson, bus driver, to 3.5 hours per day, effective March 27th. Teacher transfer for next school year, Bridget Roofer will be transferring to grade 5 classroom intervention teacher. St. Pat's would like us to hire through our auxiliary services personnel for the 17-18 school year, Nicole Manahan as a full-time intervention specialist, and Stephanie Lamore as an auxiliary services personnel clerk at 2 hours a day, 90 days of the school year. It is time for teacher contract renewal, and all of these teachers have been evaluated positively by our administrative staff and recommended for the following contracts. 1 year limited contract for Todd Grosstein, 2 year limited contract for Olivia Elkins, Lisa Heslop, Sierra Rorick, Lauren Ruppel, Jordan Whitler, Brandon Fisher, Audra Manriquez, Hannah Renalette, Stephanie Roofer, and Corbin Walker. 3 year limited contract for Scott Green, Megan Lytle, Betsy Smith, Kelly Thiel, Tyler Manap, Abby Rieger, Dan Slagle, Lindsay Slagle, Abby Hughes, Kyler Meager-Blad, Molly Siebenaller, Joe Tucker, and McKenna Swords. 4-year limited teaching contract for Robbie Lakes, Beth Klingeman, Chelsea Cordy, and Brooke Inselman, and a continuing contract for Amber Frantzor. Substitute employees for the end of the year, classified Penny Perez and Scott Stuckey. And then we also, is an annual action, non-renew our substitute teachers at this time. Again, not a reflection of their performance, it's an annual action that we take. So any questions regarding personnel recommendations at this time?
Okay. I'm going to accept the personnel recommendations for Monk.
Second, please.
I'll second.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Cinder?
Yes.
Thank you.
And next, recommend the non-renewal of Ann Newcomer as substitute teacher for the 16-17 school year.
Motion to approve?
I'll move.
Bryan. Second.
Tom? Call the roll, please.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Abstain.
Emily?
Yes.
Cinder?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
And recommend the non-renewal of substitute teacher Claudia Miller for the 16-17 school year.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes.
Cinder?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Abstain.
Thank you.
And then, unfortunately, under number three, when we were working with NEOLA, it was inadvertently put in to approve the policies that conflict with the other policies we approved for our Health Care Act in our insurance plans. So NEOLA has asked us that we rescind the following items that were approved in error. And the different numbers just reflect administration, classified staff, certified staff. It's all the same policy. So my apologies for having that be in the list, and we would just need a motion and approval of the board to rescind those.
So moved.
Thank you, Tom. Second?
Second.
Brian?
Emily?
Yes.
Cindy?
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Bryan?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Thank you.
Out of Columbus, there is some talk of a change to graduation requirements. We're starting to monitor that.
That's so surprising.
We will keep you updated with that and any progress. Budget-wise, I still have yet to hear any changes. Have you, Rob, at all?
There was some chatter this morning, some of the news releases on just the concern of revenues coming in under budget this year and how that carries over into the two-year budget cycle.
You're saying the revenues for the state are
revenues for the state are about $600 million.
Trickle down.
Yeah, so they're looking at maybe having to make some modifications to the first budget, you know, that they submitted. So, you know, it's still a stay tuned type of thing, but the news isn't real good. They don't know where they're going to make the cuts. They haven't said whether it's in education or across the board, or, you know, just a kind of a big picture is what they painted the picture this morning. That, it's not rosy.
Yeah, I heard sometime in the next couple of months we should get a little more direction.
They have to have a budget passed by June 30th, so they're going to have to make some decisions here shortly.
Mm-hmm. We're getting to crunch time. Flurry of activity expected.
Thank you.
Our next board meeting, as a reminder, we did change the date to May 8th here in the Fieldhouse Conference Room at 7 p.m. Business Advisory Committee will next meet June 15th at 7 a.m. And then, as I explained, with being on spring break this week, or today is our last day, some of our administrators are still traveling. So we excused Mr. Ruffer, but Mr. Bassett was able to join us. So Mr. Bassett will put you up first.
All right. Well, good evening. Mrs. Savage alluded to most of my report about the graduation.
Good. Well, I just gave him a teaser.
Yeah. So we talked before about them lowering points. That's kind of, I hear much about lowering points now, but instead adding an additional pathway. So we already have three pathways. Now we're adding like a fourth pathway. What that is, they haven't passed yet. There's talk of like a 2.5 GPA just your senior year, and a certain attendance rate would qualify you.
As long as you get serious by the time you're a senior, you might be able to speak.
As long as you, by the end of the junior year, you say, hey, I'm planning on track to pass these tests, I need to come to school every day and get a 2.5 GPA, you'd be fine. So it'll probably change before it gets finalized, but that's an additional path.
I think I also read that they're going to give credit for work experience.
That is correct, which I think is a great thing.
Sure.
It hasn't passed yet either, but they're talking to that. That's part of another route you could do. You could have so much attendance and get work experience during the your senior year.
Because a number of our students are doing that now. They're going to work half a day.
I think that's a great idea. That'd be just another pathway to go. We'll see how it shakes out.
The emphasis on technical skills, it is another pathway.
Yep. Like I said, I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's a good thing. Just another thing we'll have to track and make sure kids are following through if they're in that kind of crunch season there, their senior year. So we'll follow up on that. ACT test, we're going to try that again on Wednesday. They followed the first time, so our test arrived, and we're hoping for blue skies come that morning. So we can test and have to send them all back again. We are through our first round of language arts testing at the elementary middle school level. On computers. At first time we had third graders on computers. Pretty successful. I mean, you know, you have a minor glitch here or there, but our technology staff is just great at that. We have airports where we need them and we're online and we're rolling. Teachers have been great at the third graders and all new to them, and get them in the room 15 minutes later and every kid's tested. And then it goes well. So I'd like to thank them for their hard work.
Thank you. Ms. Cox is also able to be with us tonight. Yeah. I wanted to echo what Mr. Bassett was saying with our third grade students just finishing up language arts. Chad came over to help out. Gary Wise was there to help out. And Jamie Morris was there to help out. And then your administrators were there. So people were in the hallways ready to help out teachers or students that had any issues whatsoever. So it just worked out and went very, very smooth. So. Huge kudos to them. We have additional testing. We have fifth grade testing and fourth grade math testing at the end of April here coming up. And then we have third grade math at the beginning of May, fourth grade social studies, and fifth grade science. So we're going to continue on that path of having online testing go well for us. I did want to, hopefully some parents are out there that are watching this, we have huge piles of lost and found at all of our campuses. So hats, gloves, shoes, lunch boxes, socks. We have all kinds of lost and found items that we'd really like to send home with their rightful owner. So if parents have any questions, they can come and check out Central, Washington, Portland campuses. So all those items can go back to their rightful.
Is there a time of day that's better for them to come, before school, after school, lunchtime?
You know, really, and it doesn't matter. Whatever is convenient for them, our secretaries, administrators will accommodate them.
Where it is.
At the end of the year, we'll try to, if they don't, because we have a huge, huge tables with piles of belongings. So those
getting
items.
Getting warmer so they don't take their coat home.
Yeah. So those items we'll try to keep as many as we can, but there's so many that will end up going to Goodwill if they don't find a home by the end of the year. So we have, on May 10th, our fifth graders, our soon-to-be sixth graders, are going to take a tour of the 6 to 12 building, so they're super excited about that. Mr. St. Holtz has been working with Mr. Arnold to get them on a tour over in the new school. On Thursday, May 11th, our fourth grade band and orchestra students will have a parent night. Fourth grade students, fifth grade students get to do an instrument, whether it be band or orchestra, but it's the end of their fourth grade year when they're introduced to all of that. So we have a parent night on May 11th, and that's at the Portland campus. Mr. Will and Mr. Gordon will talk about instruments, demonstrate instruments, show instruments to kids and parents at that time. And then I'm super excited, on Saturday, May 13th, we have our Color Run coming up. It's our third annual Color Run, held by our PTO. They have done a fabulous job thus far organizing and getting things prepared for that. That is held behind the Portland campus.
Can you clarify, Karen, what the funds go towards? What PTO benefit, or what they help with?
Yeah, PTO, our assemblies that we have throughout the year, they donate, or they give to teachers an allowable expenditure for their students. But 100% of the money goes back to assemblies or various items that maybe teachers request. But it all goes back to students and teachers.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. A lot of it is for assemblies.
So, and then back to teachers and students. So that is Saturday, May 13th, and then we have our field days coming up here at the end of May. There's going to be a parent letter going home. Our field days have run so successfully, thanks to our parent volunteers, so there's going to be a parent letter that goes home to get some of our parents involved in that as well, and that letter will go home next week. So.
Thank you. Thank you. And from the 6 to 12 building, Mr. Reary was unable to be here tonight. Testing continues at that level as well. So the next round is April 25th and 26th for math, and of course exams for grades 6 through 10. Science will be grades 6 through 11, science and social studies on May 2nd and 3rd. So we're testing from a couple weeks ago all the way up through the beginning of May. Congratulations and a huge shout out to our musical cast and crew. I hope that you had a chance to attend. What an amazing performance. I had never seen the musical, so it was just very exciting for me, and I was told that our students performed Joseph as good as anyone. So congratulations to all of them and to Mr. Lupo. And then finally, Mark writes, the month of May brings many awards nights. We have senior scholarship night. We have concerts for end of year, eighth grade trip, prom, senior exam, staff appreciation, and spring athletic tournament. So keep your eyes out on the calendar for those upcoming events.
Okay, thank you very much. There's no other business. I do have a need for executive session under item A for employment. Appointment, dismissal, discipline, promotion, demotion, or compensation of employer, investigation of charges or complaint. For B, the purchase of property for public purposes or sale of property, competitive bidding. And for D, preparing for conducting a review, negotiations, or bargaining session. So I would entertain a motion to go into executive sessions for those stated reasons.
So moved.
Tom, please, second.
Second.
Brian, please call the roll.
Cinder.
Yes.
Tom?
Yes.
Brian?
Yes.
Glenn?
Yes.
Emily?
Yes. I just need no action, so thank you for coming.